The matter was brought to the attention of Parliament yesterday by the Shadow Minister of Internal Affairs, Betty Nambuze Bachieke, MP Mkono Municipality, claiming that 162 police officers have been given a notice to vacate Mulago with their families immediately. Nambuze asked that given the poor accommodation, the eviction be stayed until the affected police officers are provided with alternative premises.
Thank you.
And whether it wouldn't be prudent for now to stay the eviction until an alternative for this family is found. And lastly, Mr. Speaker, that last year in November, the IGP promised at a pass out of police officers that government was going to construct 53,000 housing units for police officers with immediate effect, that it was a directive of the president. I would like to know how far this has reached. And lastly, Mr. Speaker, as a way of appeal, I appeal that for now, there is a stay to the eviction as an alternative place is found for the officers who are sleeping at Mulago Police Barracks at the moment. I do so pray, right, Honorable Speaker. Thank you.
According to the Prime Minister, Robin Anabanja, these police officers are 54 and were settled in Mulago Hospital in 2016 at the height of insecurity. The Prime Minister noted that their deployment has outlived their purpose because insecurity has been mitigated. She assured Parliament that the officers in question are now going to be relocated to Sambia Police Barracks.
Honorable Speaker, Mulago wants to expand, as you are aware, and develop that place. The security situation greatly improved, and so they are going to give them patrol police instead of police who are based there. Because of other negative things that came up. And so, that Honorable Speaker, the police officers will be relocated to their original barracks.
However, some legislators insist they must be compensated because they spent their hard-earned money to put up structures for accommodation, which are going to be demolished. But the Health Minister, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, says never.
Did so with the permission from the authorities. But when the Prime Minister was responding to Honorable Nambuze's question, she did not talk about the compensation of these officers. She simply said they are going to be relocated to Nsambia and other police barracks.
Thank you.
And right Honorable Speaker, you know some of those residents are just inputs. So those who had constructed their houses with permission from the authorities, what is their fate?
These police officers occupy 4 acres of Mulago Hospital, which land is needed by the hospital to construct water tanks to address continuous water shortages ravaging the facility. Police officers have up to Monday to leave or be evicted. The development came shortly after a report by the Uganda Human Rights Commission on welfare of the Uganda Police Force highlighted issues of inappropriate accommodation for the police officers.
We had requested for not more than 15 officers. Subsequently, others, because of lack of accommodation, came into the hospital. And they were allowed to construct temporary units. Temporary. It was very clear. This is not your place of abode. We can accommodate you temporarily. When time comes, you will go. And that was the agreement. The IGP is aware that the agreement has come to an end.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.